Thank you. have a chime. That's really wonderful. That is because there's so much beautiful energy in this room right now and so much love. Good morning, everyone. Welcome. It's wonderful to see you all here, the Universalist Church, where love is the spirit. Whether you're in the sanctuary or anywhere in the world, we do have cameras zooming us out to the ether, to YouTube. Welcome, everyone. I'm Gretchen Fountain, one of your co-moderators on the Board of Trustees. If you're a visitor, we do hope that you'll talk with our welcome team or visit our webpage, www.westhartforduu.org. It should test you all, see which of you know that. We say it every day, every Sunday, so. There you can learn more about us. Our guest book or online contact page will help you get onto our electronic mailing list, which is still the best way to stay connected to everything that's going on here, which is a lot lately. We look forward to helping you become connected and become part of the Universalist Church. You may notice this morning something new and different. We have these beautiful child activity kits along the windowsills and children's books. These were the vision of our member Melody Moore, who made the activity kits by hand, and Carla Principe, who helped to fill them and supply all these wonderful books. So thank you so much to those of you who made this happen. They will be here every Sunday. Families should feel free to take a kit from, or a book, or both, from the windowsill and allow your kids, they have quiet activities in them. So they're appropriate to use here in church, and please enjoy them. Adam had a few words you wanted to say.
As Gretchen said, there are many, many things happening here. So today, after worship, I'll be holding an Article 2 conversation. It'll be the last one of the series of three. So if you're curious about what's happening with the covenant among our congregations, that is something to do. That will be in the program center at 11:30. We also want you to check the weekly notes for other events. The weekly notes are on your order of service. Some of those upcoming events include new member orientation next Sunday and the Sunday after that. It is a two-session series that we hope, if you're curious about the congregation or you've been around for a bit and you're like, I'm ready to be a member, please come to those and we'll make sure that you have all the information you need in order to do that. We actually do require you to come to that or have a conversation with me in order to join the church. We have other events listed in there as well, like Drag Bingo later this month, and we hope that some of you will be purchasing tickets for that. It is going to help support our Welcoming Congregations work, our LGBTQ inclusive ministry, and I believe it's also going to help Q+, if I'm remembering correctly. And so Q+ is the queer youth organization that we incubate here within the congregation, and so we are excited to have this also help support that work out in the world. And I think that's it for the moment.
And it will also be a lot of fun.
Yes.
After the service this morning, we will have fellowship in Fisk Hall and through Zoom. If you need help finding your way to Fisk Hall for fellowship hour, any member of the church is happy to guide you. You can certainly look for someone wearing a name tag. Just go that way as far as you can. If you hit the parking lot, you've gone too far. But you won't, because the coffee and goodies will stop you on the way. Also, there's fellowship on the link online. And if you aren't getting our weekly newspaper, please sign up for it on our website. Now, I invite you all to take a moment, make your mobile phones silent, please turn off your email, any other devices, and settle in for worship. Thank you.
If you've looked through our order of service already, you'll see that today is child dedication, and this is always one of our most fun Sundays. We try to do it twice a year. This year, we are dedicating 8 children. One was accidentally left off of our order of service, so we will be dedicating Piper Jen O'Keefe as well. And that means that the music is going to be fun, and we're going to have some laughter and happy child noises, and maybe some unhappy child noises. That's just the way it goes. But we are excited to have, obviously, the children's materials here for this Sunday in particular, and you are all very, very welcome here, no matter how young or old you are, no matter how noisy or not you are. So we light our chalice today. And I invite those of you at home to light yours too. We light it with a flame that is newborn in this moment, but comes from the flame that danced and grew before it. And we too, at times, have been new. We also have been just born. And we also have been those who have come before, whether giving life or guidance or wisdom or just effort. In this flame, we are reminded that it is our task to make sure that the things that we value continue on beyond us for those who will need it when they too are newborn, when they too just begin to dance. Our opening hymn is number 338 in the Gray Hymnal. Number 338, please rise in body or in spirit as we sing together. Please join me in speaking the words of our affirmation, our covenant. It is printed in your order of service. Love is the spirit of this church, and service is its law. This is our great covenant, to dwell together in peace, to seek the truth in love, and to help one another. Please be seated.
We are brought together for a joyous occasion by and for all of our children. and to recognize and welcome especially a few newer little ones into this circle of love today. Every day that a child is born is a miracle, an opportunity to recognize the power of love, a day to give thanks for the beauty of the earth, a day to recognize that no one is brought up alone, and that every person born is a savior to the world. Welcome to the circle of love as we work to dedicate ourselves and each other to the care and tending of these youngest among us. We recognize all who have gathered here now and those who are away from us in distance and time. We honor the ancestors who have left this world but not our hearts, and we welcome them here in our minds. I'll offer here a poem from the poet Hafiz. What is the root of all these words? One thing, love. But a love so deep and sweet, it needed to express itself with scents, sounds, colors that never before existed.
The voluntary offering, the sharing of our resources for our shared work as a religious community, is a spiritual practice for us. We offer our time, talent, and treasure to this community, to one another, and by doing that, we serve our members and friends and the wider world as well. And so as part of that service, we share our offering each week with organizations that do work in the world that brings us ever closer to creating the beloved community. We also, as a congregation, occasionally help out with some other organizations too. And so today we're going to hear from Beth Brigham on behalf of our food ministry, and she's going to talk about the Walk Against Hunger.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Beth Brigham. I'm the volunteer coordinator at Fern Street Food Ministry. Connecticut Food Share's Walk Against Hunger is Fern Street Food Ministry's biggest fundraiser of the year. Our goal this year is to raise $15,000 to help support our programs. As of this morning, we have raised $5,450. The walk is on Saturday, May 4th at Duncan Park. It is a 1.5-mile walk that starts at 10 a.m. We're hoping some of you will join us on the walk. We help over 750 households every month through our five programs. Our backpack program is celebrating 10-year anniversary this year. We deliver backpacks weekly to schools for 162 students in West Hartford. Our pantry is 8 years old this year. We serve a minimum of 85 households the third Saturday of every month. We make 260 sandwiches on a weekly basis and deliver to House of Bread on Tuesdays. My father started this program over 40 years ago. Connecticut Food Share's mobile pantry comes to our parking lot every other Monday morning with fresh food. On average, 125 households come to the truck. After the people get their food from the mobile pantry, they're welcomed into Fisk Hall for coffee, tea, and a continental breakfast. We rely heavily on this walk to help us fund needs for our programs. Lisa Scambotti will be in Fisk Hall at a table after the service today. Please feel free to stop by and see her and learn more about our programs and donate if you choose. I will be at the table next Sunday. And a reminder that the barn dance is 4/26 in Fisk Hall and all proceeds go to the Fern Street Food Ministry. We really appreciate your support. Thank you.
Next month, we'll be doing more to support the food ministry and the Walk Against Hunger, but this month, we share our offering with the Interreligious Eco-Justice Network. It's Connecticut's only faith-based environmental nonprofit. And the mission of the network is to inspire and equip Connecticut's religious communities and their spiritual allies to protect our planet through education, engagement, and advocacy. You can give to our offering this morning through the QR codes on your order of service, the links in the description on YouTube, or the links on our website to make your donation. And here in the sanctuary, our offering will now be gratefully received. May these gifts that you have given so generously sustain the life of this community, the work that we do together, and help us to serve the wider world of which we are a part. Thank you. Thank you. Please rise, in body or in spirit, as we speak our congregational reading today. It's number 649 in the back of the gray hymnal, number 649 called From Generation to Generation. Patricia will speak the words in Roman type, and we all will respond with the words in italics.
In a house which becomes a home, one hands down, another takes up the heritage of mind and heart, laughter and tears, musings and deeds.
Love, like a carefully loaded ship, crosses the gulf between the generations.
Therefore, we do not neglect the ceremonies of our passage, when we wed, when we die, and when we are blessed with a child.
When we depart and when we return, when we plant and when we harvest.
Let us bring up our children. It is not the place of some official to hand them their heritage.
If others impart to our children our knowledge and ideals, they will lose all of us that is wordless and full of wonder.
Let us build memories in our children, lest they drag out joyless lives, lest they allow treasures to be lost because they have not been given the keys.
We live not by things, but by the meanings of things. It is needful to transmit the passwords from generation to generation. We'll join in singing our doxology. It's in your order of service in the description online.
Praise God for love we all may share. Praise God for beauty everywhere. Praise God for
be seated. Before we begin our time of prayer and meditation this morning, I have one thing to share with you on behalf of the pastoral care team. Greg C's memorial service will be taking place on May 2nd at 3 p.m. Greg died very, very recently after a lengthy illness. We are both sorrowful at his death and grateful to be able to help celebrate his life. So we hope that you will come on May 2nd at 3 p.m. to help us celebrate Greg. Today, of course, as I've mentioned, is child dedication. So I invite you to hold that in your hearts and in your ears and in your experience as we pray this morning, knowing that stillness and silence doesn't always mean the same thing it means when we are on our own. We are blessed beyond measure by the children among us. The presence of people of all ages continues that blessing and the gift in this sanctuary. In one another, we meet the spirit of life, crying out, occasionally giggling. We meet the brilliance of existence. In one another, we find paths and possibilities that offer a future worth living. Each person of every age is one more person who can change the world, change a life, bring beauty, balance, knowledge, truth, and healing. So let us rejoice together. And if we need to, let out a little bit of misery too. It's okay. It's all right. But even in that, let us rejoice in all those that we welcome into our midst today. On this day of child dedication, let us dedicate ourselves to making this a better world for every child that comes into it. May each and every one of us know that we are held and loved within the circles of family and friends and this congregation and our faith too. I invite you into a time of relative stillness for the prayers of your own hearts. In one another, we meet the spirit of life, the brilliance of existence, paths and possibilities that offer a future worth living. May each and every one of us know that we are held and loved within our circles of family and friends and congregation and faith. Amen. Every so often, hopefully twice a year, sometimes just once, and during COVID, not at all, unfortunately. In these moments, we dedicate the children who have come into the congregation, whether because you have joined and brought them with you, or they have been born while you were here. And whether these children are babies or teenagers, we celebrate and welcome all of those who have not yet come of age. We offer up a promise to be alongside all of them and their families as they grow in their faith. It's important that we do this as a community, because to be dedicated into our faith is to be made part of our covenant. In other religious communities and traditions, children may be baptized or consecrated or dedicated to a particular god. As Unitarian Universalists, we dedicate our children and ourselves to a life lived within our covenants, our promises regarding how we will be with one another and in the world. We know that our children will be guided by the wisdom and beliefs of their parents and their families, and as Unitarian Universalists, we know that those vary widely across who we are, and that is as it should be. We also know that teaching children how to seek truth within a religious community actually requires a religious community. It's not something that a parent or a family does alone. It's something that we all do together, promising that we will provide a community that will enrich and nurture children into a life that is the very best life we can possibly imagine or make real. A life filled with wonder and wisdom, mercy and justice, compassion, kindness, and love.
Who here was dedicated in a UU church? In this UU church? As Unitarian Universalists, we hold dear our history of religious freedom, the promise that we make to engage in and support one another in a free and responsible search for truth and meaning. We know that our children will hear our words, watch our actions, and learn our ways and values, and then grow, following their own paths, their own passions, their own reason and intuition. We dedicate our children into a way of being, not a certainty of believing. Being dedicated into the life of this church begins a path on which every member of a family, and I hope in which all of us, will grow in our faith. Our tradition asks us to expand our religious understanding all the days of our lives, not just while we are young, and not just if we are parents. All of us are part of raising the children within our community. We each have a part to play, whether it is teaching or greeting people, no matter their age, parenting or singing our children to their classes. Whether we dedicate one child or many, this time of celebration and commitment renews us all in our promises to one another and to all those children who will become part of this congregation. This is how we keep our faith alive from generation to generation. Will, the Victor, Beale Hill Sinclair, Hare O'Keefe, Curtin, Kilmartin, and Brown DeSocio families, today dedicating their children, please come forward.
We'll have you gather here, kind of just right in front of these pews and a little bit in front of the steps too, as necessary. Hey, Ted. Leave me the and probably the microphone as well. Thanks. All right, everybody, I'm gonna ask you some questions at the very end of all of them. If you agree, you can say, I will. You do not need to look at me unless you feel like it. Will you, in your families, cherish and nourish your children in body and mind and spirit, giving freely of your own ideals and dreams, recognizing that they must develop on their own as they grow? And will you cultivate within your children a wonder for the earth and its creatures, a spirit of kindness toward all people, so that all of our children may grow into the fullness of life? If so, please say, I will. Excellent.
A the line that you are in. Hold on 1 second. Okay, can everybody hear me through the microphone? Yes, great. All right, come on forward. The rose is a symbol of each child's unfolding life, and our water, gathered together during our water communion and made holy by our presence, our blessing and covenant, is the life-giving link that makes all the earth bear fruit. And so, what are these children named? Alexander, James, and Andrew Thomas, by these names shall you be called. May you wear your names in courage, in honor, and in peace, and may your life unfold like the beauty of this flower. We touch our children or gesture, depending on how they're feeling about being touched, on their forehead, on their heart, and their hands, blessing their minds and their hearts and what they do from here on out. What is your wish for your children?
So, we're dedicating Alexander and Andrew here today because we believe this church will realize the hopes we have for their futures. We hope that they will grow up to be compassionate, self-respecting, and endowed with a will to do good. We hope that they will grow up with a loving, friendly, and kind community. We hope that they will grow up with trusted and loved adults beyond their blood family. And we see all those hopes becoming a reality already in this church. This dedication, therefore, reaffirms our faith in this church, calls us to continue living the same values we see so joyously and graciously expressed here, and binds us and our family with ties of love to a community from whom we have already received so much.
Thank you. If you would, I'm going to have you go to the back end of the line, and we'll just keep rotating people through to make life simple. All right. Brown DeSocio family, please. What is your child named?
Ivy Morgan Brown.
Ivy Morgan Brown, by this name shall you be called. May you wear your name in courage, in honor, and in peace, and may your life unfold like the beauty of this flower. So many blessings. And what is your wish for Ivy?
Mostly that I make it through this. Ivy Morgan Brown, you have blessed us with your smile, your joy, and your lust for living. We bless your eyes to see the world as it is. We bless your mind to dream of the world that could be. And we bless your hands to build it. We gift you your name, one referencing life and growth intertwining with your family's history. We gift you a family, chosen by us and for us as well, filled with kindness, caring, knowledge, and fierce love. We gift you your godparents, Chrissy and Chris, who live and exemplify values of love, caring, service, and importantly, fun. We gift you a home. We aim to fill it with comfort, joy, care, and safety. We gift you the communities we are a part of, from this church to our neighborhood, to our town and state. May our family be a blessing to them as well. Finally, one day we will gift you independence in this beautiful world. We promise to work hard to make it a better place before we do.
Would it be more helpful to have the crying one come forward next? Let's do that. Let's do that. Hi, I know, it's a long morning, isn't it? It's gonna be okay. All right. What are your children's full given names?
Dahlia Rose Victor and Sebastian Matthew Victor.
Dahlia Rose Victor and Sebastian Matthew Victor, by these names shall you be called. May you wear your names in courage and honor and peace, and may your life unfold like the beauty of these flowers. And what are your wishes for these children?
Sebastian, we wish for you to always maintain your soft, kind, and loving nature, meeting each person, including yourself, with compassion and curiosity. We pray you experience this life as an adventure full of opportunities to learn, grow, share, and connect. And we pray for you to have a community that surrounds you with love and support wherever this life leads you. We wish for you to not be afraid to make mistakes and learn from them, always knowing you have a safe, soft place to land at home. We wish for you to always know how loved, wanted, and special you are, and for you to receive the love back that you so freely give to others. We pray for you to always have the courage to stand up for others and yourself against any injustice, and for you to have faith that grounds you, bringing you comfort in difficult times and offering a foundation of hope for the future.
Dahlia, may you always maintain your vibrant, passionate, and fiery spirit. It will serve you well in this lifetime. You hold such great power within you, and we hope for you to harness that surging energy to spread love, kindness, and warmth wherever you may go, to others and to yourself. You are welcomed into a family of powerful and strong-headed women, and we see that same spark within you, an explosion of light and positivity that we deeply admire. May you always know your inherent worthiness for everything good that comes your way, and understand how truly special you are. We pray your life be abundantly filled with joy, laughter, and play, and that you surround yourself with people who nurture and support you. We wish for you to let your spirit guide you to your purpose and know that you belong wherever you are. We pray you know you are loved endlessly and unconditionally.
So I'm going to suggest that those of you who have dedicated your children, feel free to sit down in the pews up front, because it's going to be a few more minutes. We've got a number of more folks to go through. Please. Okay. So what is the name of your child?
Hannah Marion Curtin.
Hannah Marion Curtin. By this name shall you be called. May you wear your name in courage, in honor, and in peace, and may your life unfold like the beauty of this flower.
Grab it. I know it's going to hit your hands first. There you go. Would you like to hold it? Almost. I think you can. All right.
And what is your wish for Hannah?
Hannah, watching your personality develop over the past year has been an absolute joy for us. Your curiosity, exuberance, and sense of wonder have allowed us to slow down as a family to enjoy small, special moments together. You've brought so much laughter into our home and brought us even closer as a family of four. The best part of all is that there's so much more getting to know you, and we can't wait to see who you've become.
And no matter who you become, there are a few things that we hope for you. We hope you hold on to the curiosity and wonder that you have now to allow you to learn as much about the world around you as possible. We hope you draw on the lessons from your extended family and community to learn how to solve problems, work hard, excuse me, be kind, care for others, and appreciate nature. We hope you understand the value of standing up for what is right, even though it may be difficult. And no matter what happens, know that you will always be surrounded by our love.
Thank you, and thank you for helping. You're just fine. What is your child's name?
Brenna Lynn Kilmartin.
Brenna Lynn Kilmartin. By this name shall you be called. May you wear your name in courage and in honor and in peace, and may your life unfold like the beauty of this flower. Somebody. Skepticism is a virtue. What is your wish for your child?
Brenna Lynn, we are so grateful to be a part of your life. We will strive always to be a safe space for you as you experience milestones large and small. In this life, we wish for you to have supportive friendships, comfort in expressing your needs and desires, strength in handling peer pressure, reassurance when your heart is hurting, consensual encounters as you grow, space and time to explore the world, shame-free body acceptance, respect for yourself and others, time alone to reflect and time with family to celebrate, an understanding for the kaleidoscope of humanity, an exciting aging process, for dynamic movement of the body and the soul, for opportunities to get your hands dirty, for an inner compass to have fun whenever possible, and for the ability to see the strand of love that's woven through all things. We love you.
And what is your child's name?
Piper Jen O'Keefe.
Piper Jen O'Keefe. By this name shall you be called. May you wear your name in courage and in honor and in peace, and may your life unfold like the beauty of this flower. And what is your wish for your child?
Piper, I hope you continue to grow throughout your life. I hope that you learn and grow and develop into the best Piper that you can be for yourself and for others.
And Piper, throughout your life, we hope that you find your place within strong, loving, and welcoming communities. May they be a blessing to you, and may you be a blessing to them.
On behalf of the learning community, it is my pleasure to welcome your family into our faith development program. Families are the primary influence in their children's lives. Know that we are here to nourish and support you in your journey as your whole family discovers and rediscovers what is true and meaningful for you. We will celebrate with you and mourn with you, laugh with you and cry with you. Through it all, we pledge this community will be at your side.
Today, the whole congregation also makes a promise to your family. Their welcoming of you affirms their responsibility to be there, to nurture, teach, and encourage our young people. So, families, if you don't mind, one more time, I'm going to have you stand up and face the congregation.
Members of the Universalist Church, including our children and youth, please rise in body or spirit as we speak a litany for dedicating these children. I'll say a line ending with, "We promise," and then you will respond with one simple phrase each time, led by Reverend Adam. We are here with you.
Exactly.
People raise children all over the world in so many different ways, but we know that children grow best when surrounded with love. So we promise,
we are here with you.
Children need wisdom and questions, protection and experience, boundaries and freedom. To our children, we promise,
we are here with you.
Parents and families need support and kindness, time to grow together and time to grow individually, strength and peace, understanding and knowledge. To our parents and families, we promise,
we are here with you.
Teachers need someone to teach. Congregations need people to congregate. We all need each other to help us be more than we can be alone. To one another, we promise,
we are here with you.
All of us, children, parents, families, teachers, all of us need one another to thrive and transform and grow. So, in love, we each promise,
we are here with you.
And families, you may return to your seats. Everyone, you may be seated.
Thank you.
on Child Dedication Sundays, when we only have one or two children that we're dedicating, I make sure to include a homily and a whole lot of other stuff that provides some extra meaning. But today, you all did that. You have told us everything that we needed to know about what it is to have children and love children and bring them up within our community. So long as the rest of us remember that this is nothing anybody does alone, not a parent, not a family, not a teacher, but that this is our responsibility as a whole community of faith, then we will do beautiful things together, and we will raise amazing children like we always do. And we will eventually turn the world over to people that have learned the passwords from generation to generation. Blessings on all of you. Everyone in this room, everyone beyond, and especially, of course, all of the children that we have dedicated today. Our closing hymn is number 1020 in the blue hymnal. Number 1020, it's called Wo Ya Ya. And it is not something we do a lot, and occasionally it can be a little tricky, but we have the choir leading us, and the best part is that there is a chorus that I think everybody, no matter what your age is, can pick up pretty easily, because it's just wo ya ya, wo ya ya. Please.
So I'll teach you.
It's on.
There you go.
Well, I'll teach you how to sing it. So it looks a little complicated, but I promise it's not. So the first two pages, you just sing from top to bottom, and it starts like this.
We are going, heaven knows where we are going, but we know within.
And then, if we go up to the top of the second page, it says, it will be hard, which sounds like this.
It will be hard, we know, and the road will be bloody and rough, but we'll
you'll see, if we turn the page, we've got a bunch of wo-ya-yas. And you'll see at the bottom of the page, two vertical lines with some dots, which means you repeat. So it just means you go from the beginning of that section to the end, and then you go right back to those lines with the dots. And the wo-ya-ya sounds like this.
Wo-ya-ya, wo-ya-ya, wo-ya-ya.
Repeat,
and we will get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know we will. Wo ya ya, wo ya ya.
Repeat,
wo ya ya, wo ya ya.
Move on,
wo ya 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 ya, wo ya 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 ya, wo ya 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 ya, wo ya ya.
So now we'll actually sing it, now that you've learned a little bit.
We are going, heaven knows where we are going, but we know the way, and we will get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know.
We are
Nicely done, everyone. Let's speak together our unison benediction. It's in your order of service and in the description online. Engage with the world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return to no person evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the suffering. Honor all beings. And if you are able, please remain for our post-lit.